Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series for Network Engineers. This is the 8th video on Regex. In this video, we'll see how to parse route details from show run configuration. So let's try running this script once. Now you can see here, I don't have any default gateway or static route configured. So let's go to the device and configure a static route. IP route and I'll give 192.168.0.1 and let us try running the script again. Yeah, you can see here now it has taken default gateway. Now instead of this, if I give an interface name here, let's verify the configuration. Yeah, we can see here I have interface name. Now let's try running it. You can see still it is able to fetch it. So similar to that, let's configure a static route, IP route, now let's try running it. So you can see here, I'm able to even fetch the static route details what I configured. So let's see how to parse all these using Python regex. Yeah, let's go to regex 101. And to parse the static route, what we can do here, so it starts with IP route 00. Let's try giving that. And you can see here, it is matching it. Now after that, what we can do here, we'll just create a group. And at the same logic what I explained earlier, I'll use slash d and slash dot, so it matches with this IP, but there are other logics available in internet for validating the proper IP address. You can use that. So to make the script simple, I'm using this logic. But if I give any description in the middle or any interface in the middle, it won't work now. So for that, what we can do, we'll just give a dot and then plus, and now it is matching completely, but we'll give that as optional. And here in the end, we'll give a slash n. So you can see here, now it is matching. But when we interact with device using SSH, we need to add one slash r here. So let's write a logic. So it is same logic. So what I'll do, I'll copy here, copy from here. put it here. Since it is reading the file, I'll just remove that slash r that is needed only in SSH connection. Now here, let's write the matching logic. Default route match equals default route pattern dot, we are doing a search operation because here I am expecting only one output, but if you are expecting multiple outputs, you can add that find it a logic output, and then if any value exists here, just print the default gateway, otherwise no value found. So let me copy and paste it from here itself. Yeah, let us try running it. You can see here I'm getting the default gateway, but if I delete this, and run it, you can see here I'm getting message not available. Yeah. Now let's see how to fetch static route. Now let us go to regex 101 here. Let's see whether we have any static. Yeah, you can see here I have a static route configured. So that also starts with IP route. Then let's create a group here for the destination subnet. And here for static route, I'm assuming there is no 0, so I'll give not 0. So let's see here in regex what is that caret symbol means. So you can see here the caret matches starting of the string, and it will not start with 0. So let's have a look. Not 0, and the same logic what I explained earlier, /d/. Yeah, you can see here now it is matching IP address. Similar to that, let's write it for subnet mask also. And then the next hop, the destination, that is again /d/. Plus. So you can see here I'm getting three groups. 1, 2, 3. Group one is having the destination subnet. So I'll use the named groups here, ?p, and I'll give the name as destination subnet. And here you can see the group name become destination subnet, and here ?p, and I'll call this as mask. And here I'll call this as next hop. So you can see here everything is matching with group name. Now let's go to Python script. So it is same logic I'm using. So let us copy and put it into our script. Static route pattern, you can see the same logic I'm using here. Then for static route, again I'm using find iter method and I'm creating a list, and then I'm just adding all the group values into a dictionary as a key value pair, then I'm printing it. Let me just copy and paste it. This I have already mentioned here while creating the interface. Yeah, here you can see while creating interface properties I have explained it. So let's try printing it. So you can see here it is switching the static route details. Now let's try adding one more static route. Yeah, 1.2.0 I'll give, and let's try running the script. So you can see here it has created two dictionaries with key value pairs. In the next video we'll see how to combine all this and put it into an SSH connection, same like this. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.